I'm going to show you 6 simple steps to embroidering a t-shirt. I need to do some sewing mastery t-shirts, and I'm going to take this shirt and add the embroidery to it. These steps are going to guarantee that you can get your design done perfectly every single time. So this doesn't happen to you. I mean, really, what went wrong? I'm going to tell you, and I'm going to show you how to do it perfectly every single time. Hi, I'm Sarah from SewingMastery.com, where we do videos on Pfaff, Bernina, Husqvarna Viking, Brother and Singer sewing machines, and then do a short video on every page of the manual for many different models out there. I also have some amazing online courses, like the Stitching Cosmos online course and our Embroidery Essentials online course. We're going to put links below where you can check out all these courses and see which ones are right for you. Plus, we'll put links below that include the products that I am using in these videos. So if this is going to make it simpler, make sure you click on the links. Also, when you get to the end of the video, if you like it, make sure you give it a thumbs up, leave a comment, share it with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. It doesn't matter which embroidery machine you own. A hoop is a hoop. So again, just follow these basic 6 steps and you are guaranteed to have a finished product you'll be proud to wear. The 6 steps are marking the t-shirt, hooping the stabilizer and giving it a little spray adhesive, centering the design, adding water-soluble stabilizer to the top, using a ballpoint needle, and how to remove the stabilizer when you get to the end. These simple steps are going to make sure you're successful every time you embroider a t-shirt. Today, I need to add some logos to some of my recent purchases, and I want to show you how easy and fast it is. Step 1 is finding where the center of your design is going to be. Now, don't just lay out a shirt and then pick a random point, because you'll usually pick it too far to the armpit. So I've got a quick little trick for you. You're looking at the sleeve length, find the center of that. That's going to be where it's going to come across horizontally. And then you're going to peek underneath the collar, right where the shoulder seam comes up to the edge here, and then draw a straight line down. Where that straight line comes down always appears too close to the center of your shirt, but trust me, you are not flat, you are round, and so by laying this out, it does appear that this is very close to the center. You want to mark with some type of fabric marker. Make sure it's one you've tested, that it's easily removed once you are done with your embroidery. You can also use pins, like I did here. I put the shirt on, stood in the mirror, made sure I found the center point. I made sure my pins were horizontal, so I know exactly where my embroidery is going to sit. Remember, this is where you pledge the allegiance. So if you're standing in the mirror and you put your hand over your heart, that's the side you always put the embroidery on. If you're looking for great quality shirts, head over to Land's End. You'll find lots of blank shirts that you can add embroidery to. Good quality. If you're going to spend all this time doing the embroidery in the first place, put it on a good quality shirt. Here I used the Clover white marker. This is a marker that actually irons out. Keep in mind that when you use the white marker, you'll mark and it doesn't show up until it dries. So if you keep marking it back and forth, you got to let it wait for a second before it actually shows up on the fabric. So why did this shirt look so awful? I mean, I did everything that I just told you to do. I drew my line, I came down from the center point right from my shoulder seam, and it stitched out beautiful. The problem is I have broad shoulders, and this particular brand of shirt just sits differently on me. What I failed to do was try it on before I stitched it. Otherwise, I would have seen that the line was going up the side of my shoulder, and I would have known better before I stitched it to change the horizontal line. So whenever possible, try the shirt on or have the people who will be wearing them double check, especially some shirts. Some of those simpler ones, like the black Land's End shirt, those are pretty standard and you won't have those issues. On a side note, if you're looking for a template of your actual design, stitch it out on 2 layers of cutaway stabilizer. Skip the fabric, and then you can cut this out and position this on your item and to make sure everything fits and looks good before you actually stitch it on the actual item. Speaking of cutaway, that is the only thing that should be underneath a t-shirt. You need the support of a cutaway stabilizer for the t-shirt to look the best the longest. So I'm hooping up two layers of a no-show mesh. This one's a little more soft and drapey. So next to my skin, it's very soft and doesn't let that stabilizer kind of be scratchy. If you're doing anything for a small child, underneath a onesie, or any of your favorite guys who are a little sensitive, make sure you use the no-show mesh. In a pinch, it's no problem to use your traditional weight of stabilizer. Just make sure you always use two layers. You didn't think I was gonna hoop the t-shirt. That takes too long. I'm gonna show you a super easy way. We're hooping that stabilizer and using some 505 spray to give it that sticky base that I'm gonna lay the t-shirt on. 505 spray is a temporary spray adhesive. It doesn't stink, and you always spray the stabilizer, never the t-shirt. So now this has just the right stick to adhere the shirt in place once I take it to the embroidery machine. Step three, make sure you put a ballpoint needle, if you're working on t-shirts, in the embroidery machine right now. If you don't have a ballpoint needle, a universal needle will do. And don't forget, some of your shirts have a lot of Lycra. If for any reason you get some skip stitches along the way, put in a stretch needle. So something to always have at your fingertips just in case things don't go as planned. Now remember, don't get hung up that I'm not using your exact embroidery machine. But I will tell you, all machines usually do what I'm gonna show you. So our next step is to move the needle to the center of the design. Right now, the needle is hanging out where the first stitch is going to be taken. So that's off to the side. That's not what we need for aligning the shirt. We still need to get the t-shirt in there somehow. You need to find where you can move the needle to be showing in the center of the complete design. On the Fav Creative icon, it's in the precise positioning area, and touch the center. See how that moves to position? And then touch number two. So right now the needle is in the center of the hoop, completely aligned. Now I'm gonna put my shirt to line up with the needle. Next, turn the t-shirt completely inside out before you bring it into position over the sticky hoop. Right now the t-shirt's just kinda hanging out right above the hoop. I don't wanna touch it down just yet. You can even turn the needle down into the center of your marked line. And now just make sure that your line that's horizontal is lined up with the edge of the hoop. Usually you have some type of mark off to the side that you can make sure it is completely lined up with. Once it's completely aligned, just go ahead and start to finger touch the t-shirt down to that sticky 505 spray that you've already adhered to the stabilizer. And one other thing that I like to do is stand over here to the side and with my eyes look right down this line from the complete left side of the machine. I can tell right now I'm not totally lined up, so I'm gonna just give it a little adjustment until that line is completely straight. Once you're happy with the location, bring your needle up before you touch anything on the screen, because the hoop is probably going to move. If you do have pins in place, this is the time to remove them. Get them completely out of the way of your moving foot. Step five is my last little trick. I'm going to take some 505 spray and just kind of spray a little bit of water-soluble stabilizer. That's gonna just help it stay in place while it is being hovered over the top of my embroidery. And this, why do I use water-soluble stabilizer on top? That's gonna keep the stitching, the embroidery, from sinking into the nice soft waffle weave of a lot of the nicer t-shirts these days. It really puts a nice finish, keeps everything nice and smooth looking, but without getting sunk down into the nap of the fabric. Before you start embroidering, just make sure nothing has caught around anything or slipped itself underneath the hoop, so it is completely clear of where you're going to do the embroidery. A lot of machines these days have what's called a basting box option, a place where it's going to just do a quick tack down around the outside of your design and really stitch the shirt to the stabilizer so it doesn't move. So I've selected that and I'm going to go ahead and start stitching that first. first. And this is also a great way to really see if you have got everything lined up exactly where you want it to be. So if this box is not to your liking, you have one last little time to change where it is actually going to stitch. I can see right now that my line compared to my basting box is very parallel to each other, and I'm happy with the location. I have one more step for you, a quick trick on how to get that water-soluble stabilizer out from inside those tiny letters without ever putting this in the wash. So if you want to wear this the minute it comes off the embroidery machine, I've got a great trick for you. Plus, I'm going to show you how much stabilizer you should leave on the back side. Another benefit of floating the t-shirt on the stabilizer like I showed you is that you don't have any hoop marks. So if you are needing to use this shirt, the minute it comes off your embroidery machine, you are ready to go. Flip it over to the back side and then just go ahead and clip any of the stitches to remove the basting box. That's what I've done first. And go ahead and take this completely out of the hoop. And now we've got this stabilizer we need to trim. So I'm going to show you really quick how much we need to leave. I'm going to just kind of pull the rest of those little stitches. And also we need to remove the stabilizer from the front. So you can just go ahead and right now just kind of pull. It pulls very easily off as the stitches have perforated it, and it gets all the outside parts off. But I can see just a little bit of this shiny part still inside the letters. I'll do that last. But let's come around to the back side. So here's something you don't want to do. You don't want to just go ahead and start cutting your stabilizer. Where is the shirt? The shirt is behind the stabilizer. Oh my gosh, don't do it that way. You have to do it with the shirt between your stabilizer and your body. If you don't do that, there's going to be a day that you're probably going to cut the shirt, and that's definitely not what you want. You do want to leave about a quarter inch to a half inch all the way around, but I'm going to just, and it doesn't have to be pretty, but it just has to be trim. So you can see that I'm making sure that I can see my shirt at all times, never trusting that it is you definitely don't want to get it in the way. Now that wasn't the perfect little trim job, but I'm not also going to worry. The other thing that I did do on my machine was I turned off the thread cutter. So if your machine cuts in between each of the little jumps, it might leave a lot of little extra tails back here. At the end, I had one tail. That's the last of my bobbin thread. I can trim that off, but it really keeps the back of my shirts nice and clean. So I do prefer to have the thread cutter turned off. The last trick I have for you is take a wet paper towel, lay it over that stabilizer, and take your iron and just kind of bring that heat over the top of the design. I'm just really using the nose of this just right now, but that's going to help pull up the water-soluble stabilizer out of those little tiny areas. Perfect and ready to wear.